I have a story back in Australia. There was a sheikh that I met, and he said he used to teach back at Lebanon. And there was this girl studying for her year 12 exams. He said she would come to school and stay over hours and study extremely well. But she came to the sheikh, who was her teacher, and she used to complain. She used to be always crying. She said, "Ya sheikh, I have a problem with my mother. She overworks me. When I go home, she overworks me. And I do work and I've got to study for my exams and I'm trying my best. Wallahi, I do not disobey her with anything. And she is so harsh to me." She made a dua to me today. That's why she was crying. She made a dua. She said, "May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you fail your exam and never pass." And she said, "May Allah not be pleased with you." So she said, "I'm crying, Ya Shaykh, and I'm studying hard now to try and beat the dua of my mother." So the Shaykh gave her advice and said, "Tawakkal ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." True story. And he used to see this girl studying. Just before the exams, by about 2 weeks, she stopped studying, stopped coming to school. Subhanallah. And she did her exam and failed. The following year he met her, or he asked her friends, said, "What happened to that girl?" They said, "Subhanallah, Ya Shaykh. 2 weeks before her exam, her mother was crossing the road and the car struck her. She died. Her mother died. And as a result, the girl was so distressed over her mother, she couldn't study anymore. And she failed her exam. The mother made a dua against her daughter. The dua was not good, so the mother died. And the girl, obviously it was written for her, but Allah, mashi'atillah, the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala works with things is unexplainable. And the girl failed. She passed the following year. The point from that is, and his sister was asking me, should I do the nafl prayer or respond to my mother and father? We answered that. You respond to your mother and father and then continue nafl prayer. But I just wanted to mention, the dua that parents make against their children in these circumstances, be very careful about them. We know that the hadith al-sahih, which is in Muslim, that Rasulullah ﷺ said that three types of dua will never be refused. And one of them is the dua of a parent against the disobedient child. He also said, لا تدعوا على أنفسكم. Do not make dua against yourselves. ولا على أولادكم. And not upon your children. ولا على خدمكم. ولا تدعوا على خدمكم. Don't make dua against your servants. ولا تدعوا على أموالكم. Do not make dua against your wealth. عَسَىٰ أَن تُوَافِقُ سَاعَةً يُسْتَجَابُ فِيهَا فَيُسْتَجَابُ لِدُعَائِكُمْ. Do not make this dua because you may coincide with a time where Allah is accepting du'as and your dua will be accepted. Be very careful with these du'as, my brothers and sisters.
يا صاحبي اسمح ثوان أمسلك بجرح العنيد أمسلك بجرح العنيد لا زال نزفة يحتويني واجز عن دواه وزيد واجز عن دواه